I remember when I first started making beats, one of the worst experiences that I had was when I found out that some of my friends were making fun of me behind my back. At the time, I'd been getting serious about beat making, trying to actually get better, and it was something that was really important to me. I would spend hours and hours, pretty much all of my free time, practicing and learning, which is something I'm sure you can relate to. And I remember I eventually got comfortable enough to play my music to some of my close friends, and I told them that maybe this is something that I was thinking of pursuing. And after this, what happened was I found out that some of them were actually making fun of me behind my back, saying that my beats were awful and how much of a joke it was that I was even trying to make beats. And this did not feel great. I found it pretty hard to deal with, and for years I felt really uncomfortable playing my music for anyone. Now, this might be something that you have or will go through, where people around you may not be supportive, and at times they might even do the opposite. They may even actively discourage you. You may run into people like this in real life or in online comment sections, people who will just say things to make you feel insecure about yourself. Now, when I was going through this, what happened was I accidentally just randomly stumbled upon a quote. It actually really ended up helping me, and it really changed my perspective. And that's exactly what I want to share with you. It's from Teddy Roosevelt, and the quote goes as follows. It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, and who at worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. And when I read this quote, it really helped me realize two important things about beat making and what I was trying to do. For one, what we've all decided to do is something that is really brave. It's brave because it can feel like a big risk to send an email to an artist and ask them, "Do you like my beats? Would you be interested in working with me?" It can feel like a big risk to post your beats online for everyone to hear, knowing that the view count's probably not going to be all that high, but you post it up anyways. It can feel like a big risk having all of your failures be on public display for everyone to see. And it takes a brave person to know all these risks and still decide to try anyways. What we're doing can easily fail, but that's exactly what separates us from everyone else. Most people choose to go down a safe path because they don't want to experience all of the failures and disappointments and frustrations that we choose to. Which by all means is okay. That's a decision that we all make in our lives in one way or another. But when it comes to beat making, this is where we've decided that we're going to be different. We've decided to do the hard thing, the scary thing, the thing that might fail. We've decided to step into that arena and try to fight for what we want, which is something that very few people ever do with anything. So after I read this quote, I felt like I got a better understanding of myself and what makes people like us different than other people. Now, the second thing that I learned was more about the people around me. When you first start making beats, the people who are in your life will probably react in a few different ways. There will be people who encourage you. When you fail, they will be there to support you and help you get back into the arena. These are just great people to have in your life. But then there are others who are like the people that I mentioned in the beginning of the story that will try to put you down for even trying. And what I eventually came to understand about these people is that they do not like the fact that you decided to try something, and they like it even less when you end up trying and actually succeeding. The reason why they don't like this really doesn't have much to do with us. Actually, it has more to do with them. For them, all of this negativity and mockery and the put-downs are just things that they need to do. Devaluing and belittling others is what helps them feel better about themselves. That's their coping mechanism. All they're trying to do is make themselves feel better about their own decision to stay out of the arena. Because stepping into the arena, that requires bravery, and not everyone has the courage to do this. And when I came to understand this, it really helped me deal with these types of people a lot easier, and I realized that I shouldn't really take anything that they say personally. Some people are just willing to bring down others if that's what's going to help them feel better about themselves. It's just not unusual to see that the most vocal critics are the same people who actually never tried to do anything themselves. It's just a lot easier to sit in the audience and criticize the people who are in the arena than stepping in it yourself. So if someone says something negative to you or about you, just take a moment to remind yourself of this quote. These are just people who are in the audience. They will say and do whatever they have to make themselves feel better about not being in the arena with you. And that includes making you feel worse about yourself. But you'd be making a mistake in letting these people dictate what you do or how you feel. You are in the arena, and that alone is an accomplishment because so few people ever try to step in the arena themselves. And that's something that you should feel good about. I hope this video has helped, and that's all I have to say for this week. I'll see you next time.